Hey guys, what's going on? I got a whole day to myself, so I thought I'd come out today and actually practice some bushcrafting skills instead of bushwhacking all day. Normally when I come out, I like to explore and walk areas, and I usually wind up covering miles and miles and never getting to cut anything or make anything. So I think I'm starting to get rusty on my skill set. So I thought today I'd come out, have some lunch, and collect a few pieces of fat wood, which you saw me collect earlier right here, and I collect some dry grass. So I'm gonna try three methods of fire today. I brought my fire kit, or my flint and steel kit, ferro rod and fat wood, and this is a set I made off of sycamore a few months back, and no, it's been longer than that, probably 6 or 7 months. Yeah. Anyway, I'll have to check my Instagram, because last time I made a fire was whenever this was put on there, and I just made the set. I keep them dry and carry some with me sometimes. I know a lot of people say, well, that's cheating, but actually it's not. Indigenous people made sets and carried them with them for that same reason. When it's wet, you're not always guaranteed a friction fire, so it's nice to keep tinder with you and something like this. But anyway, let's see what we can do. Right now it started out in the 40s, but it's almost 68 degrees now. And I got hot walking in here in that wool shirt, so I had to actually take both of them off and hang them up. It's warm, but it's threatening rain, so right now I'm gonna get a tarp up, put my shirt back on. I think it's dry now, and get a tarp up, and then we'll go from there. So stay with me. Let's have fun. So the tarp I'm going to be putting up is this little snug pack Stasha. It's a 64 by 96. In case I put it up, anybody's wondering which one it is. All right, so bushcraft project number one. I found two of our old stakes. This is the spot I come to quite frequently. But these are two of my old stakes. I found them sitting on the ground, but I needed two more, so got to make two more stakes. All right, I was going to put it between those two trees over here originally, but decided to put it over the log, give me a place to sit. Also, I got to looking above, and there's no widow makers up here, but some of those branches look a little more threatening. So, plus, like I said, this give me a place to sit and all my gear to go under and everything. So, now let's move on. Alright, so fire number one. Do the fat wood and the ferro rod. Of course, now that I'm starting, the wind's starting to blow. Alright, that's very resinous right in here. So I want to get to that before I even start scraping. hard stuff. There, you can see how resinous it is in here. That's what I'm trying to get to. Alright guys, I moved over here to this other log because that one was too soft and it was sinking. But I don't have a flat surface here, so let me just see what I can do. Alright, let's see if I can ignite it without knocking it off. There we go. Fat wood fire. So there's one. Now let's do the flint and steel. Alright, let's go to the second one. It's windy, so it's blowing my stuff everywhere. I know it's gonna blow my sparks away from me.
That was almost too easy. Here we go, flint steel. Now, I'm gonna have lunch before I even attempt the bow drill.
Kept lunch pretty simple today because I knew I was going to be doing a lot of actual bushcrafting and didn't really feel like cooking. I'm going to make me a tea here in a minute, but I kept it pretty simple. It's just sardines, cheese, crackers, almonds, and some chocolates. I wish I'd brought a couple of spring onions to go with this, though. That'd be real good. I just realized that I've got to make a bow for this bow drill set. I brought the hearth, the bearing block, and the spindle, but I didn't bring a bow, so I made sure I've got 325 paracord. And, so we gotta go find a bow. Alright guys, I gotta hurry. I'm running out of daylight. I either get it or I don't. Anyway, I burned it in. I notched it, so I'm fixing to give it a try. And then I gotta get out of here. I still gotta pack all my stuff up. Alright guys, so it's smoldering. It's good to go, but I'm not going to bother the transfer because this is a small ember. I didn't build it up good because, like I said, I got to get out of here, man. I had about 30 minutes of dark till dark, and then I got a little over a mile hike through the woods, and I don't feel like doing it in the dark. But anyway, thanks for coming with me today, guys. I really, really had a lot of fun today, and I'm glad you got to share it with me. All right, take care, and we'll see you guys in the next video.